For this video, we're going to demonstrate how to add a requisition to an existing menu item. First, we're going to show you where the requisitions are located. From an empty speed screen with no items on the left-hand side, in the bottom portion of your screen, you're going to see a button for options, so we're going to click on the options button. Middle portion of your screen, under the open liquor column, four buttons down, you're going to see an admin button. You're going to click on the admin button. On the left-hand side, four buttons down, you're going to see System Settings button. You're going to click on the Systems Settings button. Middle portion of your screen, under the Printer column, you're going to see Requisition Routing. So we're going to click on Requisition Routing button. And you're going to see that there are four preset requisition routings. You have the bar, cold kitchen, hot and cold, and hot kitchen. On the bottom portion of your screen, you're going to see a back button, so we're going to click on the back button. We are now going to add a requisition to a menu item. On the left-hand portion of your screen, three buttons down, you're going to see Menu Management button. You're going to click on the Menu Management button. By setting up requisitions, you are setting up a path for menu items to be directed to specific areas within your establishment. For example, if you order hot menu items, you can set up your requisitions, which would send the hot menu items to the hot kitchen printer in order for the staff to make the menu item. So now let's demonstrate how to set up the requisitions to an existing menu item. In the middle portion of your screen, under the modifier options column, five buttons down, you're going to see menu items button. So click on the menu items button. We are going to add the bar requisition to Beck's Beer. Under the department column, you're going to click on Beer. Under the items column, you're going to click on Beck's. On the bottom portion of your screen, you're going to see a button for OK, so click on the OK button. On the right-hand side of your screen, you're going to see requisitions. You're going to click on the down arrow, and you'll see a pull-down menu appear. You're going to click on bar requisition. In the middle portion of your screen, you're going to see a button for save, so you're going to click on the save button. Once you have clicked on the save, anytime that a customer orders a Beck beer, it will automatically go to the bar printer. Next to the save button, you're going to see a close button, so click on the close button. Now we are going to add the hot requisitions for the buffalo chicken wrap. Under the department column, we're going to click on food. Under the menu item column, we're going to click on buffalo chicken wrap, so click on buffalo chicken wrap. In the bottom portion of your screen, you're going to see a button for OK, so click on the OK button. Right hand portion of your screen, you're going to see requisitions. You're going to click on the down arrow, and you're going to see a pull down menu appear. And you're going to click on hot kitchen requisition. In the middle portion of your screen, you're going to see a button for save, so click on the save button. And when customers order and you enter buffalo chicken wrap, it will be automatically set to the hot kitchen printer so the staff can make the buffalo chicken wrap. Next to the save button, you're going to see a button for close, so click on the close button. In the bottom portion of your screen, you're going to see a button for back, so click on the back button. In the bottom portion of your screen, you're going to see a speed screen button. You're going to click on the speed screen button. And that is how you add a requisition to an existing menu item.